अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू विल बी फाइन एंड वेल। अकॉर्डिंग टू टूडेज लेसन प्लान, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर एक्सरसाइज ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 1 फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 7। दिस एक्सरसाइज इज़ रिलेटेड टू नेमिंग एक्शन एंड डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स, सो लेट्स नो व्हाट आर दीज। नाउन्स आर नेमिंग वर्ड्स। पीपल, प्लेसेस, थिंग्स एंड एनिमल्स आर कॉल्ड नाउन। पीपल फॉर एग्जाम्पल टीचर, पुलिसमैन, फ्रेंड, सिस्टर आर नाउन्स। And names of places, beach, park, house and zoo, these are also noun. And names of things, present, apron, cake, razor are also noun. And names of animals, for example, flamingo, monkey, cow and whale, these are also noun. Action verbs are also called verbs. These shows actions, for example, play, eat, watch, drink, read, sing, sleep, run, dance, draw, shop, talk, cook, swim, travel and study. These are few examples of action verbs or verbs. Let's know about describing words. Describing words are also called adjectives. Adjectives are the words which show the quality of a noun or pronoun. Here are a few examples of adjectives or describing words. For example, fuzzy, grubby, gaudy, grumpy, gentle, handsome. These are a few examples of adjectives or describing words. Now let's move towards the exercise. Read the given advertisement carefully. Find and write two naming, action and describing words each. Use them in your own sentences in your notebook. This is the advertisement. Let's read it out. Fruits and vegetables mall. 20% discount at your first purchase. Get fresh, healthy fruits and vegetables delivered on your doorstep at low rates with just one call. Here is the phone number. Now you have to find two naming words. There are several naming words. For example, fruits, vegetables, doorstep, rates, call. These are all nouns. And now you have to find out action words. And the action words are get, delivered. These are the action words. And now you have to write any two describing words. The describing words here are fresh, healthy, low, one. These are the adjectives or describing words. Write any two and then use all the given words which you have written here. Use them in sentences. Now come to the next exercise. 2. Learning to spell. Fill in the missing letters to complete the words. The first is word, WORLD, word. The second one is complete, COMPLETE. The third one is honest, HONEST, honest. The next one is truth, TRUTH, truth. The next is forgive, FORGIVE, forgive. And the last one is dozen, DOZEN, dozen. Now let's move towards the next exercise. This exercise is related to common and proper nouns. Read the given sentences and notice the use of common and proper noun. Before moving towards the exercise, let's know what are common nouns and what are proper nouns. Common nouns are names of a class of people, places, animals or things, for example, boy, school, pencil, etc. Proper nouns are names of a particular person, place, animal or thing. They always start with a capital letter. For example, Azlan, Faisal Masjid, the Holy Quran. Now, let's see the use of common nouns. My grandmother lives in a village. Here, grandmother and village are common nouns. I made a cake for my mother. Here, cake and mother are common nouns. There is a masjid near my house. Here, house is common noun. She likes to play with a doll. Here, doll is common noun. There are beautiful mountains in my country. Here, mountains. And Country are common nouns. Now let's see the use of proper nouns. Allama Iqbal is our national poet. Here Allama Iqbal is proper noun. They went to the Faisal Masjid. Faisal Masjid is proper noun here. Nida reads the Holy Quran in the morning. Here Nida and Holy Quran are proper nouns. The national animal of Pakistan is Markhor. Here Markhor is the proper noun. Muhammad Ali Jinnah is the founder of Pakistan. Here Muhammad Ali Jinnah and Pakistan are proper nouns. Now let's move towards the next exercise. Here underline the nouns in the given sentences and write whether they are common or proper nouns. We will go to Rawal Lake next week. Here Rawal Lake is noun and this is proper noun. The next is, my father is a hard-working man. Here father and man both are common nouns. The third is, it is a huge building. Here building is also common noun. The fourth one is, Islamabad is a beautiful city. Here Islamabad is proper noun. And city is common noun. The last one is K2 is the highest peak of Pakistan. Here K2 is proper noun. Highest peak, here peak is common noun. And the last one is Pakistan. This is proper noun. Solve this exercise on your books. Now let's move towards the next exercise. Read the given paragraph and notice the use of countable, uncountable and collective nouns. Now first of all let's see what are countable nouns, what are uncountable nouns and what are collective nouns. Countable nouns. Countable nouns are nouns which can be counted. They have plural forms. Uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are nouns which cannot be counted. They don't have plural forms. For example, rain, weather, pain. Collective nouns are names for a group of people, things, or a collection. Now let's read the paragraph and see the use of countable, uncountable, and collective nouns. Hira went to the shopping mall with her mother. There were many shops. Here shops is countable noun because it has the plural form and it can be counted. They went there to buy fruits and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables are countable nouns because they have the plural form. Hira's mother bought some onions. Onions is countable noun. A bunch of grapes. A bunch of grapes is collective noun because bunch is the collection of something. And a dozen of bananas. Again, dozen of bananas. Here dozen is collective noun. Hira went to the bookstore. Bookstore is countable noun. And bought a new storybook. Again, story is countable noun for her friend. She also bought a bouquet of flowers. Here a bouquet of flowers. Here bouquet is a collective noun for her father. They also enjoyed tea. Tea is uncountable. With chocolate cake in the cafe. Here chocolate cake and cafe both are countable nouns. It was a good experience. Experience is uncountable noun. Come to the next page. Here there is an exercise. Write three countable, uncountable and collective nouns in your notebook. Then use these nouns in your sentences. This is your homework. Do it. I hope you have understood today's lesson. Now learn it and complete your homework on your notebooks. Thank you for listening. Allah Hafiz.